Hello, I'm Mehrdad and welcome to my channel. In this video, like the other videos in my channel, I'm going to talk about a project. Let's see what this project is. This project is about making a dashboard for human resource management. All of us know how much important human resource management is in every single company. And in a human resource department, we have a lot of data that all the staffs are dealing with those data. So handling this data and having good insight about the human resource data can help organization to have a better decision about their employee, or even they can improve their performance. So in this project, I like to talk about how we can create a dashboard for a human resource department in a company. This project data comes from a real data for a company, but it is just a slice data or some months of data, and we want to talk about this. But before this, based on this cover, we can see we have two steps. One steps. We are going to pre-process and clean data, and after that we jump to data visualization sections. If you follow my videos in my channel, you can see all the projects have several steps. Some of them have some just one step, some of them have several steps. This project is separated into two sections. Number one, we talk about data pre-processing and data cleaning, and after that we talk about the data visualization. Both these sections are done with Microsoft Power BI. In this project, we want to work on Microsoft Power BI, and we want to take full advantage of that to run this project. Now let's jump to data documents. My projects have a report, a PDF report. You can find all the files. The file of the project, the data, the report, all of them in my GitHub profile that you can find the link in the description of this video. Now let's go to the report of this video. It is the report of the video. You can see the name of the project. It is HR management, and we have two steps. You can see my information. If you are interested to see my profile, you can click and each section, my GitHub, my YouTube channel, my LinkedIn profile, or you can send an email to me. In the content list, we can see this project is separated into two sections, two main sections, data pre-processing and data visualization. But every project has some specific and default section. One of them is the project goal. Project goal means what we are going to do in this project. And after that, we talk about the language, the libraries, and the tools that we used for running this project. And in the next, we talk about the data documentation. Data documentation is crucial because whenever in the project you are wondering what data is, you can refer to data documentation and see what's going on there. After that, we jump to data pre-processing. We run three steps, transforming data and building the parameter, because we are going to work in a Power BI. Then we build some measures and metrics that in this section we use the DAX languages. Then we normalize date column, and after that we go to data visualization. Let's do all the steps step by step. Number one, we are going to see what the project goal. The project goal is, as I mentioned before, we want to clean and pre-process the data in Microsoft Power Query. Microsoft Power Query is a good feature in Microsoft Power BI. You can use Microsoft Power Query for pre-processing or clean data, and after that, you can use Microsoft Power BI for visualize data. We want to use both of them. And after that, in a Microsoft Power BI, we can create an interactive dashboard. The interactive dashboard, it is something that sounds to me, it is very interesting. And you can find some dashboards which are made with Microsoft Power BI in other applications. So I'm fond of the Microsoft Power BI. the languages that we use the Microsoft Power Query and DAX. And the application is Microsoft Excel for dealing with data and Microsoft Power BI. About the data, let's see what data is. Here, as I mentioned, we have three different sheets for real data about the HR management for April 2022, May, and June. This data is about the attendance of every single employee in a company. If you can see, for example, for April, we have all days of April, and every employee has a label. What this label means, you can go to attendance and you can see, for example, P means the present, PL means the paid leave, or SL means sick leave, or half day PL. All of them are some conditions that every employee can come across during working in that company. And based on these conditions, the company pay money and salary to them. For example, if you are sick, one day you are not going to go to work, so HR department puts, for example, sick leave or SL in the front of your name for that specific day. And after that, at the end of the day, when the company is assessing and measuring the salary for you, they can consider these conditions. So it is very important for that company to have better insight about these data. And in this project, we can see what insight and what information that company can capture from this data. We have for May, for June, and we want to combine and aggregate them for the company in a Microsoft Power BI and make a dashboard and make some visualization and insight to the managers. And now we can talk about the goals of the project and what can we extract from this data. The managers for this company have two main goals. The first requirement that HR management is about the preference of working for employee. During the COVID-19 pandemic in that company, some employees wanted to work at the home and they want to work remotely. Whereas in contrast, there were some employees they were willing to work at the workplace because they thought in that case their performance increases. And in this project, we can see for every single day which employee wants to work and what is the performance. As well as that, the company has some specific limit for the resource. For example, a company is willing to know in which specific day they have the most number of employee. Because in that case, the company is going to set aside a lot of resource, for example, a laptop or other resources to employee. And if in a specific day there are a lot of numbers, the company will have a lot of problem because they don't have a lot of laptop or other resources. And they want to have a balance in a week and in a specific day, they have a balance. For example, in a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, give this opportunity to employees to have the good resource from the company. The other sections or the other goal is the level of sickness. For example, the company is going to know in which specific of leaving at work they can consider, yes, now we can say the COVID-19 pandemic or the sickness level in company has increased. Because in this day or in this month, there are more than 15% or more than 10% of employees are absent. You know, with this information, the company can figure out, they can decide whether the prevalence of sickness is high or not. Because if you remember the data, let's see the data again. Because if you see the data, in this data, we just see some labels and some days. And if the company wants to have those insights and those goals that we talked about it, we cannot capture any data from here. But with visualization and analysis of the data, we can have good insights to managers. It is where the data analysis come to play and help the managers to have better decision for the company. Let's go to the next step. In the next step, we want to work on the data pre-processing. In data pre-processing, we must work on some specific things at the first step. In the Excel, we have April, May, and June. So it means we cannot work in every single spreadsheet, and after that, we combine them. Because in this case, we have just three spreadsheets. What if we have 10, 20, or even 100 sheets? We cannot do the same process for all of them manually. So it makes sense. We build a parameter. What does parameter mean? The parameter mean we work on just one specific sheet. We do every single data pre-processing on that. For example, we want to change the name, remove the outlier, remove the null value, or whatever that you think about data pre-processing and data wrangling on just one single sheet. After that, we create a parameter or we create a function, and then we apply that function for other sheets. You know, this parameter and this function can save a lot of time, and we want to work on this project. For example, in the first, I import all sheets. For example, the April, the June, and the May. The attendance key is just that sheets where we talked about which data label means. We don't want to work on that. And it is the preview. After that, I import the data just for April 22. And I run all data pre-processing steps. For example, I change the name, I change the type, I unpivot table. In unpivot table, you can see we have 22, 23, 24, 25. It means I unpivot, I convert all of them from horizontal line to vertical line. I show all of them during the project in a Microsoft Power BI. I just giving you some basic steps and basic insight about the data. And after pivoting table, we change the type, change the rename, and it is the final here. It is the final view for April. And we did everything. For example, with this employee, for example, I cannot read the name, Thomas Tucker, in this date, he was P. So if you are interested what does P mean, you can go to attendance key in Excel sheet. Let's see, for example, the Thompson Parker P in the first day of April. April, the first day, and P. P means present. It means in that day, this employee was present, was working at the workplace, and a lot of information about all employees. It did just for April. After that, we run everything about the April. We can create a function, and we apply this function for all of them. So for doing this, I create a copy from the data, and I work on April 2022. And I convert it in a advanced editor in Microsoft Power BI, convert it to transform. It means now I have a parameter, I have a function. I mean, I convert all these steps to a function, and then I'm going to apply this transform function. I'm going to apply this function in data set. The data set is here. So then I do this, I invoke the custom column. It means I'm going to apply the transform function to all data. And I did this process. let's see the data after applying the function to all sheets. In Microsoft Power BI, we can see the data sets. This data set is the data set after applying the function. We can see we have all information about April, May, June for all employees. And all of them have some values. What is the value? The value is the present, for example, the sick, have all the attendance level. And there are some other columns. Don't mind that. We want to talk about them. I just wanted to show you the data. So far we have the data and we want to go further. In the next step, we want to build a metric and measures. Before data visualization, it is very important for you to create all measures, or at least the most important measures and metrics. What does measures and metrics means? The measures and metrics means we have used DAX language to have some parameters, to have some measures, and use them during the project. Because if we create the measures and we create the metrics at the beginning of the project, we can save time during the data visualization process. Let's go to Power BI and talk about the metrics. It is my way, when I'm going to create a measure and metrics in Power BI, I do this process separately. For example, you can see we have the data, we talked about it, and we have the other table for measures. I put all measures in a specific column. The first measure that I run is total working day. As a data analyst, I wanted to know the company's data is about the April to end of June. But what is a total working day? April to June, it makes sense. We have some holidays, we have some weekends, and we want to know how many days specifically are considered as a working day. So for doing this, I create a measure with DAX. I create a variable as a total days, regardless they are holiday, they are present day, they are working day, just a calendar day. And I count the number of data sets. Why I use this? Because if you remember the data set, in a value, we have all steps or all conditions for every single employee. And all of them are associated with the date. So if I count the values, it means I count the all days between April to end of June. So it is the first variable. The second variable is total non-working days. And for doing this, I can say among these days, among all the dates, all days, the total days, just count these two labels, work off or holiday off. If you see the data, you can see the work off, the holiday off, means they are non-working. It means the company was closed in these days and no employee couldn't work. I just count the labels, the values that considered the WO and HO. It means if I do this, I count all non-working days. So far I have total days and total non-working days. So if I subtract them, I have total working days. And it is my total working days. You can see it is very simple DAX, but even these simple DAX can help us very much. The next DAX function, or the next measure I'm going to create, is total work from home. In some specific days, the employees wanted to work from home. That day was not holiday, that day was not off, and some employees wanted to work at present, some of them wanted to work as a WFH, work from home. So I count again all working days and just calculate some of them that are WFH, and it returns total work FH. With this, I could find all number of people or all number of data that employees wanted to work from home. The next, I'm going to talk about the total present. But for total present, we must go to dataset first. Let's go to dataset. You can see here, I have a present score. The present score is another DAX function, but it is a measure, it is a column. If you know, just for tutorial, if you know in DAX, we can create two different things with DAX, measures or columns. The total working days and the total WFH were measure, but the present score is a columns. It means I want to give a score for every employee who was working at present, not work from home. For example, if work from home, they can score 1. If work from home and work from office or half work gets 0.5. And if he or she work at the present, at the company, get a score 1. So, and it's an if condition, and in this concept, in DAX, it is called as a switch and true. For example, if I select this one, you can see the score is 0 because HLWP, let's see what's HLWP. It is half day leave without pay. For example, an employee came to company work and after the leave. So in that case, we are not going to that. It is a score 0. But if I score, for example, P, we can 1, and what does the 0 WHF, for example, if it is half work from home, it is 0.5. So for column, I could create present score. It means I create a new column in my data. So now I'm going to have a total of this column. The total of this column means total present, because we have work from home, work in the company, or work half from home. So all of them means the all scores about present. And I create a DAX with sum. And the next is about the leave score. The leave score is, again, I'm going to create another measures in the dataset. Let's go to dataset again, and it is the leave score. For example, if an employee leave for sick or leave as a HSL, what HSL means? The HSL means half day sick level. So it means, for example, this means the employee was completely sick and she or he didn't want to come to company or work from home. But the HSL means half of the day they wanted to work, and the rest of that they leave the work. So for doing this, we have 0.5, and for doing this, the leaving score is 1. And if we have the sum of them, we have all leaving for work. So far, we have total leave and total present. And then we can create the percentage of people who work from home. It is just a percentage. And we have the percentage of people as a present and percentage of people leave. So we have all the measures, and we are ready to go to next step. So in this document, you can see all the steps that I did during the working on a project. It's a good report, and I suggest you read this report at the same time that you are working with the data. In the next, I'm going to talk about the normalized date column. It is on my way. Whenever I have a date column in my data, I'm going to normalize data, specifically when I'm working in a Microsoft Power BI. Because in a Microsoft Power BI, there are good features like a DAX that you can take full advantage of that to normalize your data. What does normalizing data means? It means you separate the data from year, months, day, weeks, and so on. Because otherwise, date, just a label. And the label cannot be useful for data analysis. So for doing this, I create a custom column. I'm working in this section. I just close here. In this date, I create the DAX function. In the DAX function, I create a new table. In this table, I use calendar function in DAX. And I say the minimum value is the data set date. The data set date is exactly this date. This date comes from here. And when we unpivot table, if you remember in the beginning of the project, I talked about I unpivot the table. And I'm going to extract, I'm going to normalize this data. So for doing this, I create a new column or new table as a date. I use the calendar and the minimum value of a date and the maximum value of a date. It means now I have a spectrum and I have a scale. During this scale, from this date, that is the minimum number, and this date, that's the end of the June, the maximum number, I'm going to extract the year. To extract the year, I'm going to extract the number of the months. I'm going to extract the name of the months. For the name of the months, we cannot use the month's name. We use format. The date, and in this format we can have the name of the month. I'm going to extract days. I'm going to extract the weekdays. It is the day, it is the weekdays. For example, in Saturday, in this day we can see we have the Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and so on. So we normalize the data, and the combination of that we can have a good visualization. I talk about all these steps, and yeah, in this step, when we create the date, we have two different dates. One date is the old date that we have in this data, and one date is the new date that we used it for working with DAX. So, which of them should be used for the project? If you ask me, the best thing is the table or the normalized date that you created. Because you have the normalized date and you can handle them very well. So for doing this, you should create a model or create a relationship between that old date and the new date. So I have a data set here and I have a date here. It is a date table, it is a data set. I create one to many, and one to many you can see from date here, we have the relationship between these date. And it means I'm going to use these dates instead of having this date. For example, I'm going to ignore this date, and instead of that, I'm going to use this table. And it is very, very useful, because if you have this table for data, you can have the day, weekday, month, month name, year. And if you have just this date, you have the unnormalized data or denormalized data. And you cannot have good insight about that. So now everything is ready, and we pre-process the data, we aggregate the data from the several sheets, be create some measures and parameters and metrics with DAX, we create columns, and we normalize the date. Let's go to the next step. The next step is the data visualization section. The data visualization section, we wanna create a dashboard for the company. The main goal for creating that dashboard is having two goals, two basic steps and basic requirements that the company wanted to know. If you remember here in the first of the document here, yeah, the company had two requirements. One of them is about they can have insight how they can manage the resources and how they can have a balance, a number of employees every single day. And in the next, they want to know the level of attendance or the level of present at work. That's why we create the total of leave, total of present, total of working from home. Because with these measures, with this information, the company can figure out which percentage of their employee are working from home, which percent of the employee are working in the company, or how many of them are absent in a specific day. So in this visualization, we can answer both questions or even more than these questions. Let's go to the visualization or dashboard. I just go to here. It is the dashboard that I create for the company. In the next, we can see the title, and we have some slicer. We can see the April, June, and May, and it is the automative. For example, if the company add the other data, the May is added to June. However, we have June is added to July, August, September, October, and so on. In the next, we have the search button. For example, if I search, for example, I want to see which name here, Joel Cruz. In the first glance, I cannot see the name, but if I search a name, I can see the Joel Cruz and here, and this is information about him. So it is the table. That table have some information. For example, in this table we have the name of the employees, and it is the present and leave. The present and leaves here, if I click here, you can see we have the present, the measures for present. This column comes from here, the percentage of the employee, the performance of employee about presenting at the workplace, and it is the performance of employee in terms of leaving at the workplace. How many during April, June, and July this employee was working from home or from the company, or half of them, if you remember 0.5, and it is how many percentage that employee was not working. For example, if we can see the highest number, this employee, Alexander Davenport, and other people having the highest number of present and the lowest number of leaves, means they were working whether from their home or at the workplace, and they have the least number of leaving. So it means the company can say yes, they are maybe they love their job and they could work, and they leave the company in the least level. However, for example, these people, the April Ayers, have this number of leaves, and in this case, the company can go into detail and see what was the specific day. And in the middle of the report, we have some information about the present. For example, the total number of people who were present, the percentage of presenting, and it is good, it is more than 90%, and it is the distribution of presenting in a weekdays. For example, in Wednesday, we have the highest number of presenting, and the company should know why we have the highest number of presenting at the Wednesday. Maybe, for example, in the Wednesday, people are in the middle of the weekdays and they prefer to go to work. By the way, what is the least number? The least number is a Sunday, and it makes sense because Sunday is holiday. But it's a Friday because it is at the end of the week. People don't want to work, or they want to, for example, leave the work or work at from their home. About the work at the home, the total number working at the home in this month was this number, and it isn't very high number, and it is the trend, and it is the data about the weekdays. For example, in the Friday, we can see in the Friday we have the least number of working at the company, but whereas we have the highest number working from home. It means the employee wanted to work at the end of the day at their home instead of going to company, because they want to back to back having the work from home, go to holiday, go to in the weekend. So what about the Monday? In the Monday, we can see the people wanted to come back to company instead of staying at the home. And about the leaving, fortunately in this company we didn't have a lot of number of leaving, and it makes sense because the company was very strict in precaution and some hygienic matters. The percentage of leaving totally was 1%, and it means there was not any COVID-19 or other sickness prevalence in that company. But the highest number of leaving in that company was 2.41 for Monday. Just for an analysis, maybe in the weekend people eat a lot, or they were working outside and they were sick and they couldn't work either at the work from home or at the company. So let's see the data, for example, just for April. If because this data is interactive, if I click, for example, just for April, it is just the data about April. In April, we have this information. For example, in April, we have just 7 number of people leaving the work, and the percentage of leaving was this number. But if we go to June, we can see the percentage of leaving was increased. And the data, overall the data is different from the June from to April. And what about the May? In the May, we have the highest number of leaving and the lowest number of present. And for example, if we want to select all of them, I want to see, for example, one specific employee, for example, this Ray Novak. I want to see the data about this employee. I click, and this data about here. For example, the Ray Novak, in this month, just 53 times he worked at the company, and the highest number of present, it means in this 53 times he worked Friday, Monday, Thursday and Wednesday, and about the Saturday and Tuesday, in some Saturday and Tuesday he didn't want to work, but for other days he worked all of them. About the work, just in Saturday and Friday, one in Saturday and one in Friday, he wanted to work from home. And about the leaving, in the leaving, he leave the company 2 times. One of them was for Tuesday in April, and one of them for Tuesday in May. And it is the overall overview. The total present, the total performance of Novak for present was 94, and the total leaving was 3.75. Orally, the company can use this dashboard and use this data for having insight and having information about their employee. The company manager, the HR managers can use these dashboards to make a decision about the performance of their employee, about working in a workplace, working from home, or other measures. They can use the this data for creating new measures, because at the first glance in this data, we didn't have a lot of information, we just have a label. But if we work in DAX and if we work in a Power BI, we can see we have a lot of data and we can make a lot of information. By the way, I hope you enjoy this video and thanks for your watching.